the baddest, the biggest. He been doing it for the longest, been doing it for the strongest, bitch. It's the end of the world. These are the last days. This might be the last day. And lucky you, on your last day, you gonna hear the Busta Rhymes album. You lucky bitch.
Lucky bitch.
Well, it's the God.
Yes.
No illusions, blessings while I greet y'all in the absence of confusion. For signs to spark the mind with thoughts of greater living. It gets deeper than secrets and Masonic symbolism. And I understand if you can find it extremely hard to calculate it. How this dude will refer to himself as God. Let me demonstrate it, you don't get it at first, revisit it later. But in the meantime, let's examine the difference in our nature. As in loving or hateful, patriotic or rebel, positive and negative, or in God and the devil. It's been debated for years, let's acknowledge the magic. While some embrace the joy, others have witnessed it as tragic. But I'm addicted to exposing the truth as a habit since a youngin', using a pencil to write my mathematics, incorporating the science while I give you the classics. While some are finding strange and resort to measures that's drastic, I articulate with clarity, reassure when you hear this. Some identify me as cuckoo or conspiracy theorist. Some may call me crazy cause at times my life seems out of order, thus possessing answers to the total square mileage of land and water. Go get your recorder, cause even on my worst day, when I'm weak and the weight on my shoulders, I can tell you what the earth weighs. Let me listen to the wind so I can hear the earth, me and the universe speak round a celebration of my birthday. That being said, we can stop pretending in our mental, like all the shit we witnessed be happening coincidental. See, back in 98 when I dropped the first extinction level, I was fighting in the demons with personal scores to settle. They put it in a movie cause they knew that we ain't really know. Funny how they try to tell us 22 years ago but deeply impacted how watching the flick really moved me as the world was ending. Morgan Freeman was present in the movie. So let's fast forward to 2009, the 2012 movie left an impression on the minds of the people, making sure we remember if we slightly doubted that the world was ending and we can't really do shit about it. Damn, funny when I saw the flick it did amuse me through, to the point where Danny Glover was present in the movie too. Then I questioned why they reiterating the same plot. Should we be a little paranoid? They gave us Barack. In 2020, the message I'm sending, now that my president gone, how convenient the world is ending.
I tried to warn him with the seventh seal. The world is wounded. It may never heal. Even Mother Nature's getting ill. It's getting real when millions get killed. When that deadly weather spill, until Sodom and Gomorrah's on America's turf, the horror, it'll forever get worse. Yet and still, it's like a gift at birth. Then you inherit a curse, but the meek must inherit the earth. It's heaven's will. Meek meaning powerless in the form of politics, giving power at the dawn of the apocalypse. The war is stronger than peace. It's poverty to the majority, it's scarred with the mark of the beast. So the righteous prevail or work miracles. Repair the weather you through the unbearable and reverse the inevitable. Refine you a sin, remind you a win. Back when God lived in men and that time was again. Signs of the end, read Mark chapter 13 and Daniel chapter 12. Understand you wrapped in hell. Revelation show the facts as well. Then read prophets in the Quran and ask yourself, do you rep a nation bred for hating? Judgment day ain't far, don't get left debating. Cause what they thinking is the end of creation. It's actually the reincarnation of God's, the death of Satan.